Now I'm Grim Grindle, welcome back to the first Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts video on this channel in a little while. As I'm sure some of you have noticed, it's been on somewhat of a hiatus for a little while, but it's back in force. I am going to try my best to upload at least one Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts video every fortnight going into the new year, so if you're subscribed to this channel largely because you're a Nuts and Bolts fan, that's good news for you. And if you're a subscriber who's in it for the other content, well, good news to you as well. We're going to also be aiming to do at least one not nuts and bolts video every fortnight also. And I suppose if you enjoy both the nuts and bolts and non-nuts and bolts content we put out, it's going to be doubly good news for you. For most of the rest of the year, the nuts and bolts content we're going to be putting out will be build requests, but to begin with, I'm going to first do another builder's guide to nuts and bolts. Although, technically, this builder's guide is on something that is probably one of the most requested things I get, so, I guess it's almost a build request, but whatever. And so, as you can probably tell by the comments on the screen, today we're having a look at the VTOL, which stands for Vertical Takeoff and Landing, which I suppose technically my Pelican is, but I get the impression that people are wanting something that does this, with it being a little bit smoother and a little bit fancier. I have also had requests for specific VTOL vehicles. This one's just going to be looking at the mechanic generally. That's not to say that I'm not going to do specific ones later, but this is not a replica, it's a vehicle of my own design that's just going to experiment with the VTOL mechanic. So I suppose to begin with, I should probably clarify what this vehicle needs to do in order for me to consider it to have been a success. And I really believe it's all in the title. It's a vertical takeoff and landing vehicle, and so it should be able to take off vertically, fly horizontally, and then land once again in a vertical manner. As you might well imagine, the most simple way of doing this is by utilizing a folding propeller. It's also the most stable way of doing it because it's actually using a mechanic in the game that's supposed to be used, and so because it's doing what you're supposed to do and utilizing parts within the game, it's of course very boring, so let's move straight along. The second option is of course the caged option, which I use for my Pelican. I'm not going to go into it in detail here because I've already done a tutorial on the Pelican itself, but to recap on it very briefly, you have the superjets that are responsible for the forward thrust in a cage, so you can disconnect it when you need to take off or land, and then when you're at the altitude you want to be, you simply reattach it and have some fun flying around. If you want a more in-depth explanation on this method, there'll be a link to that tutorial in the description and at the end of the video. But in this builder's guide, I've decided to go for a VTOL with moving parts in which the same means of propulsion is used for the upward lift and forward momentum, which of course means that whatever is actually causing the momentum needs to be able to move, which means we're once again utilizing the greatest and most diverse part in all of nuts and bolts, the tow bar. The first attempt at this was fairly simple. It was just two superjets in a middle swivel held in place with four tow bars with a central gyroscope allowing me to reposition it. It worked okay on the upwards lift, but when moving it forward, it just wouldn't stay in position and pretty much spiraled out of control and was utterly useless. It's an okay helicopter, but it's definitely not a VTOL. Although helicopters might technically be VTOLs also, I don't know, but you know what I mean. The obvious solution to this is of course adding some tow bars at the front, so when you move the jets into the forward position they lock in place, although unfortunately this means they can't be moved back without disconnecting the tow bars, which disconnects all of the tow bars, which means the middle section falls out, which means that it becomes a VTOL, because while it has a vertical takeoff, and while it can fly horizontal, it's really not got the vertical landing. Also, it should be noted that the game responds really weirdly by the looks of it when you're using this method. What you're seeing on the screen right now is not lag, the video is not jumpy, this is how the vehicle is handling in the game. So, that's super weird. It seems to be getting caused by the gyroscope getting locked in place, and I'll probably experiment with it later to see if it can be harnessed to actually do something useful. And so, moving on to the final method that works most successfully, I've made it so not only the jets themselves, but the entire flying rig, including the wings, rotates around the cockpit. This means that you can have it pointing both upwards when you're taking off, and then rotate the entire thing forward when flying around. Then when you're ready to land, just rotate the whole thing upwards again, and you can land vertically. This method works extremely well. The fact that the wings are attached to the entire rig means that it's a lot more stable, and so they're not constantly repositioning themselves while you're flying, which means that you don't need tow bars to lock them in position, which means that since they're not locked in position, the gyroscope's not going to be constantly messing up the physics engine. And also means that you're free to reposition the rig into the landing position when you're ready to set down. Some less obvious elements of this build are actually the purpose of the gyroscope itself, which is just to move the flying rig up and down. It's not really for maneuverability, but just because sometimes it gets a little bit stuck, so having that little bit of extra control on lifting and lowering that shell can come in real handy. So it probably goes without saying that you do need that gyroscope actually connected to the shell that you're moving, and not the main part of the vehicle that's connected to your driver's seat. But what you do want connected to the main part of your vehicle is an unpowered small propeller. If you've watched enough of my Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts videos, you've probably learned that the propeller, even when unpowered, is extremely helpful in making your vehicle more stable. It tricks the game into thinking your vehicle's a helicopter, and allows you to control it differently, and basically changes the way that the physics engine interacts with your vehicle in the game. Why that's helpful in this case is because it means that while you're moving the outer shell up or down, the main section of the driver's seat stays in its orientation rather than following the rest of the vehicle. And then finally, if you do want to be more tricky with your flying, once your engines are facing backwards, you can set up some folding wings to lock the engines in place. And so there you have it, a VTOL capable of vertical takeoff, horizontal flying, and vertical landing in Banjo-Kazooie Nuts and Bolts. I hope you enjoy applying this method to creating your own cool vehicles, and if you want the vehicle you're seeing on the screen right now, when I stop talking in a second, there'll be a layer by layer of it, so you can copy it into your own save. And so, as always, thanks for watching, and until next time, I have been and still am Grim Grindle, and you have been watching A Builder's Guide to Nuts and Bolts on the VTOL. Scott.